بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, I will recite from Surah As-Saffat. A paragraph from the Quran gives you, I don't know how to say it. From one angle it's amazing, from one angle it's terrifying. From one angle it contains glad tidings. Let's read and see, and then we send the message. In the context of talking about the people of the Jannah, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, عَلَى سُرُرِ الْمُتَقَابِلِينَ يُطَافُ عَلَيْهِمْ بِكَأْسٍ مِّن مَعِينَ بَيْضَاءَ لَذَّةً لِلشَّارِبِينَ, he was describing some of the things that the people of the Jannah will be enjoying. The food, the drink, the friends, the colleagues. He came to, فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضِ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ قَالَ قَالَ, I will read in Arabic, then I will go one by one in English. فأقبل بعضهم على بعض يتساءلون قال قائل منهم إني كان لي قرين يقول أئنك لمن المصدقين أئذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أئنا لمدينون قال هل أنتم مطلعون فاطلع فرآه في سواء الجحيم قالت الله إن كدت لتردين ولولا نعمة ربي لكنت من المحضرين. Go back. Now, at a certain point, while they are sitting in the Jannah, enjoying their life in the Jannah, some of them will be asking about one of their friends, colleagues. Exactly, it says, then they will turn to one another inquisitively. You know, they will be asking each other. One of them will say, brothers in the back, please. Brothers in the back, please. Can you reduce the voice? Brothers in the back. لو سمحتم الإخوة والأخوات في الخلف صوتكم لو تكرمتم الله يكرمكم. الله يجزيكم خير. Please. You are not enabling brothers in the back to listen. جزاكم الله خير. If you please. بارك الله فيكم. Thank you very much. One of them will say, I once had a companion in the world, this worldly life, who used to ask me, do you actually believe in resurrection? You know, mockingly. أنت من المصدقين? Really? من كل عقلك يعني أنه أنت من المصدقين? I used to have a friend who used to ask me, do you believe in the resurrection? Mocking him. When we are dead and reduced to dust and bones, will we really be brought to judgment? You know, it's as if, you know, when we say in the slang language, يا راجل شغل مخك يعني, respect your mind. How come you believe in this kind of myth and this خرافة and this unseen? How come? قال, he will then ask, would you care to see his fate? This person who was asking about his colleague, his friend, will be asked, would you care to see this person's fate? Where is he now? Then he and the others will look and spot him in the midst of the hellfire. Allah will enable them something maybe similar to a screen like what you have now, camera or something. Allahu A'lam, in some way, a tool that he will be enabled to see the people in the hellfire. They are in the Jannah, but they can see them in a way like now we have many ways. قال, then and others will look and spot him in the midst of the hellfire. And he will then say, by Allah, you nearly ruined me. Had it not been for the grace of my Lord, I too would have certainly been among those brought to hell. This will happen in the day, not the, after everything is finished will happen. The people of the Jannah in the Jannah and the people in the hellfire, they are in the hellfire. One of the discussions, I used to have someone who used to make fun of my faith. He used to tell me, he used to attack, where is he? Look, He's in fire. Alhamdulillah. لولا نعمة ربي I was about to be with you now. So what is the message? The message, please, let's be careful whom to take as a close friend. Because this friend was about, لولا نعمة ربي, he was about to be lost with him in the hell fire. Because he was pushing him to reject the faith. He was pushing him to make fun of faith. He was pushing him to reject completely the whole idea of al-akhirah. So who is your friend? Who is your close friend? Who's your companion? Who's your colleague that you spend time? طبعاً definitely I mean by the first and most important, our kids. But when I say that, some people they say, okay, alhamdulillah, we are saved. You know, the adults, parents. No, not necessarily. In many cases, even the parents, they are lost because of their colleagues. Wallahi, I know cases by names, by persons, males and females. Some of them, I know a good number, around less than 10, directly I know by person back home. And the age of 40 plus, they left the hijab. 40 plus, married, they have kids. Sometimes when a young girl, still very beautiful, still the desire is killing her, she's just 18, 17, 20, not married yet, she would love to, you know, to as we say, you know, say, to enjoy everything. You can understand that, see, with the logic of the human being when she leaves the hijab. But 40 plus, 45, 5 kids, most of them in, you know, in her toll, she's approaching 50. She decided to leave the hijab. Go and dig, you know, beyond the surface and see what's the reason. You will discover friends. Friends with whom they are spending most of their time. With the people of Shisha, Hookah, Argila, Weed, something. You know, all the time, NBC, all the time sitting together, all the time watching the same thing, all the time the same interest. At the end, you know, keep talking, nagging. At the end, okay, I don't care. So some of them, they will start thinking that who said that the hijab is fard. Some of them, you know, they will be misled and brainwashed by someone like Adnan Ibrahim, for example, okay, who's very well known. How, unfortunately, or some kind of atheist, or for whatever reason, they leave the adults. And we know some adults, big fathers, they started to drink alcohol because of his friends. Now let's review who is the close friend of mine. And I finish this. Sometimes I sit with some people, they say, when I try to advise people that I know, be careful, this person, you know, he's drinking alcohol, he's doing such and such, he's be careful, I mean, he close. He said, yes. Actually, you don't know about him that he's committing zina as well. And he's drinking alcohol. And sometimes he takes drugs, but wallah, he's very nice. He's what? Very nice. Very nice with you. That's true. But have you asked yourself, is he nice with Allah? in your words. The idea. So look how we are brainwashed. As long as personally with me, in my personal interests, he does not hurt me directly. It's not a big deal for me, the fact that he's committing zina or drinking alcohol or sitting in the nightclub or whatever. And we don't notice that at a certain point, I know many cases about people, they kept the friendship with this category after they started practicing Muslim, but they did not disconnect themselves. Any weakness points, just he has a quarrel, disagreement, very angry from his wife, he left home while having, you know, the shaitan is controlling him in this moment. At this very specific moment, he say, forget. Yeah, Ammi, don't think about women. Just come and drink. He will drink. That's it. Return that again to that life. One moment. Because he is what? Close. And you know the very well-known story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, Allahumma salli sayyidina Muhammad, dhakri bil ayat. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سبيلا يا ويلتى ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد اضلني عن الذكر بعد اذ جاءني وكان الشيطان للانسان خذولا عقبه بن ابي معيط Who is the second one?
عمرو بن
شهاب. No. عقبة بن أبي معيط and another one. Two of them from the كفار of Quraysh. One of them, it is said that he accepted Islam and the other friend kept pushing him. And one of the narrations he said was about Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was invited by, I forget the name of the other one. One of them is عقبة بن أبي معيط and the other one, I forget his name. So one of them, while the other, who is the influencer, was leaving Mecca, this is the reason why these ayat were revealed. وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. Behold, be aware of the day where someone will be, you know, يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. It's an Arabic expression of showing regret. You say, I wish if I did it. I wish if I did it. This is like an Arabic well-known metaphorical expression showing regret. Regret. That I wish if I have done or if I have not done it. قال يعد الظالم على يدي. At the day of judgment, this story, two of them, one of them left. أمية بن خلف. جزاك الله خير. Yes. أمية بن خلف وعقبة بن أبي معيط. So أمية was outside مكة. عقبة was inside مكة. So at the time of the Meccan. The Prophet Muhammad was invited by Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt to like a lunch or a food. In there at that time, so Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم refused to eat. He said, لا أكل حتى تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. I will not touch your food if you do not witness that there is no God but Allah. You know, in the Arabic expression, he felt embarrassed. He said, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد محمد رسول الله. We have different narrations that he said it because he was embarrassed. And some narration they said, no, he said it because he believed in that. Anyway, he said it. So the rumor, you know, spread that Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayt became a Muslim. When Umayyah ibn Khalaf came back from his travel, he heard that his close friend became what? A kafir. He became what? A kafir in the religion of Quraysh. He committed kufr. From the point of view of he committed kufr in the religion of Quraysh. So he went immediately to him. He said, it's true. He said, no, don't worry. It's just, you know, I was just embarrassed. He could have left him and that's it. He said, no. قال والله وجهي من وجهك حرام. بيتي عليك حرام. طعامي عليك حرام. وبيتك علي حرام. حتى تأتي محمد وتبصق في وجهه. He said, by Allah. No. I just leave it easily just to tell me, no. I want to make sure. Look, he's a kafir. But he's dedicated for his case. He said, by Allah, I will prohibit for myself to see you or to sit with you or to have your food. It's prohibited for you to come to my house or to see me or to have my food till you go and spit in the face of Muhammad. If you don't do it, and some narration they say he did it, and after he did it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it come back to his face and it make like a sign in his face, you know, to the end of his life. But he went and did it to confirm that he is committing a kufr. And about عقبة بن أبي معيط and أمية, Allah revealed وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ. Mention how in the day of judgment, a person will be biting his, you know, fingers out of regret. And we say, يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. I wish if I had took the path of the Prophet. يَا وَيْلَتَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. I wish if I did not take such and such person as a close friend. لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ إِذْ جَاءَنِي. He pushed me away, you know, he deluded me away after I received the haq and the straight path. وَكَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ لِلْإِنسَانِ خَذُولًا. So what's the message? Let's check again. Who is the close friend and close friends of our kids, daughters, ours? Let's check and review. Anyone, if he's toxic, poisoning, he must be cut out of our close circles, or God forbid, we might face a difficult destination. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم. السلام عليكم.